800,000. That's the number of kids that used to be suspended from California schools every year, more than the number of high school diplomas issued. That's until a group of determined young leaders from Fresno, working with the Building Healthy Communities Initiative, transformed school discipline in their city. At a board of directors meeting for the California Endowment, the largest health foundation in California, these young people opened the eyes of the adults in the room to how zero-tolerance school discipline policies were harming their school communities. They spoke of how their friends were being suspended from school for minor offenses, things labeled disruptive behavior or willful defiance. They spoke of how their friends weren't dropping out of school. These policies were pushing them out. Soon, the California Endowment heard from other young people at Building Healthy Community sites across the state who were seeing the same problem. How youthful mistakes were turned into criminal charges, driving students toward the school-to-prison pipeline. They spoke of how failure to earn a high school diploma would reduce their friends' life expectancy by 5 years and increase their chances of being on public assistance or abusing drugs, and how these policies were having the opposite effect than intended. Schools with the highest rates of suspensions and expulsions often had the lowest rates of academic achievement. But these young leaders from Building Healthy Community sites across California didn't just define the problem, they also presented solutions. Developing leadership skills for students, encouraging restorative justice policies in school, and offering training for teachers and administrators so they could improve communication with students. Improving campus climate by supporting positive discipline that keeps kids in the classroom and promotes a sense of belongingness. With the support of the California Endowment, these young people truly exemplified people power, how engaged citizens, especially in marginalized communities, are often best suited to identify problems affecting their neighborhoods and solutions that can make a real difference. The passionate work by these young BHC leaders empowered their community to make their schools better. But this grassroots effort wasn't just limited to building healthy community sites. The message spilled out across city limits, drawing attention from other young leaders across the state and inspiring them to take action. Community activists collaborating with school officials and policymakers to make real improvements in schools by replacing zero tolerance with restorative justice. Over 8 years later, the results are dramatic. Suspension and expulsion rates are down in many areas by 50%. Graduation rates are up an average of 10% throughout California. And state legislators have taken notice, passing bills to make restorative justice part of school policies across the state. Most importantly, the efforts of these brave, intelligent young BHC leaders has created a formula that shows how change can start with a small group, grow to serve a community, and then spread across all of California and the whole country. And that sustained people power can create a whole new dynamic for those in our most marginalized communities, so that young people aren't fighting to beat the odds. The odds have changed. For more information, visit the Building Healthy Communities website.